I got the cash in the bag, stadium packed. Born a rock star in this life, gonna live it up on the attack. Baby, I'm bad. I just wanna get caught up in this life. I'm crazy, I'm mad. Doing no cap. Only God wants you, better go live it up. Cash in the bag, stadium packed. Baby, I'm bad. Yeah. Baby, I'm bad.
now back with the Lions. Here's Riley Patterson on for the field goal.
From the left hash, a chip shot here.
Patterson's kick is good.
Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for it.
You're exactly right about that. And this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
Each team with a field goal as the kick is away. From his end zone, here's Rashid Shaheed. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
New Orleans Saints, they get ready to set up shop for their second drive.
Yeah, they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
And not on now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Cameron Sutton, and his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Certainly not his best throw that time, and not a good time to make it, Charles, when they were a nickel with five defensive backs on the field.
And that's exactly why you have those five DBs out there. You want extra speed on the field, guys who have ball skills and understand what the passing game can do, and gives them a chance to react and make a play on the football, and they take one of those away.
After the interception, here's Goff. Inside the 20. And he's brought down, but not before a gain of 13. Down to the 13. First and 10 in the red zone. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. Dad plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Second and 3 with the ball sitting on the 5. Here's Goff. Touchdown, Josh Reynolds, a 5-yard touchdown, and the Lions have taken the lead.
Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And the lead is now 10-3. Kick this one away, and off it goes. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Saints offense going to head out now late in this first half. And with just under a minute to go, they might try to think about mounting a drive here if they can and get in the end zone. Could potentially tie this game up.
to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he short arms out of just a bit. It's low and incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. On the slant, complete to Michael Thomas. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They'll come up now, third and 3. Now Carr. Look in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down. Throwing now is Carr. This one swung out here to Jones. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and 1 forthcoming. Again, it's Carr. There's Chris Olave. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number 1. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Carr now to throw. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets 2 more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Throw out wide, he's incomplete.
But it looked like he marched to the end zone. He's hit a momentary roadblock, but not a completion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions. Have them looking at 3rd and 10. Now, Carr again.
And based on my math, they've only converted 1 time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
And his kick is right there. It's good, and that'll bring them back within 4. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this 1 possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number 1. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As well as man of the offense.
He has a touchdown pass, and that amounted to the only touchdown of the game for either team thus far.
In the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. For this Lions offense, set for a first and 10 at their own 23. Now Goff. He'll leave it for Montgomery, complete. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it'll be second down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Goff now to throw. And that's hauled in by Shane Brown over the middle. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 31. A yard all they need, but it's third down. Goff. That is caught. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they get five there on third and two. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the 38 now, here comes second and eight. Goff. And his throw is incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Here's Goff. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. And they stop him up short of the first down as they get him at about the 43. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down.
That's a nice design there, but sometimes, though, you get so many blockers out ahead of you, they kind of slow you down and force you to adjust. You always appreciate guys trying to help you, but maybe one less there could have turned this into a bigger game.
And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. This is taken at about the 14. So a good punt there, but a very strong 14-yard return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Yeah, both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Second and a couple. Up the middle, it's Williams. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but eventually they'll be left with a third and two.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense. Linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Give him the third down conversion. 5 yards on the play.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Brian Branch from the secondary in on the tackle.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
Carter's throw caught by Olave. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 10 yards, good for a Saints first down.
And it's pretty evident that this passing game has been frustrated so far. They haven't really moved the ball the way we might have expected, but this is a good pickup here for the first down.
Carr now on first down. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
Offense is moving it a little bit, out back on their heels, but they earn a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Here's Carr to throw. Here's Johnson with a reception. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue. Not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
But gets them that much closer.
This game is unfolding like a really good book, isn't it? Because I feel like there's a few more plot twists yet to be revealed before this one is over.
So we're back to a one-point game now as the kickoff comes. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. So out now come the Lions. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10.
Pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
In motion, the tight end. On second down, Montgomery. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup on the first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating defensively. You're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
On first and 10, here's Gibbs. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're second and one. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if you picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to second and one is probably better than picking up the first down because in college football, the clock stops with every first down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see, he'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well. I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Here's second and 10. From the 50, it's gone.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football to places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Goff. And he's taken down here by the Saints. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Yards on the punt, just 2 on the return, and that will come the offense as they take over. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. Carr gonna lead the Saints up here first and 10 at their own 21. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't it?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They got to go thank the guys on D.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. Back to throw here. And that falls to the ground, incomplete.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example of that last play.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30.
That could very well be a defining play in this game. A touchdown, that gives them the lead, and they took a major step towards getting there with that big play right there.
All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10. Carr to throw again. He's got Thomas yet again, complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Here we go, first and goal. They'll fake the jet sweep, but instead it give up the middle to Williams. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Quick hitter here, it's complete. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline to talk over what to do next. This crowd doing all they can. Here's third and goal. Third and goal at the 4-yard line. Jamal Williams taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Saints have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
And this is the time of game where offensive lines can really dictate a team's fortunes. It's been a tough battle. They've been out there for a long time. But this was a question of who can wear down who. And that's excellent work to put a long drive together and finish it with a touchdown run to take the lead.
Carr to throw. And it is incomplete, so they can't convert for 2. And now the lead stays at 5. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play. Focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team booms it away. And inside the 30 at the 27. So here's Goff and the Lions. Down by 5. A minute 24 to go. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on 1st and 10. Jones, and down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set, but I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
Plenty of time and two timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here. Now it's gone. He'll find Jones again, complete. Second down, 8 yards to go. Goff now to throw. And that one's going to come up a little short. It's incomplete. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or drape ball over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback and then make sure you blanket the field.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down. Desperation time for Goff on fourth. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Just about do it.
Partner, they took a knee to finish this one off. To me, that's the only thing they lost in the fourth quarter. How about that comeback?
Yeah, trailed coming into the last frame. Got it done, taking the knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. Second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.
So that'll do it.